another point quickly. So on the one pager that they have a sentence that says that Marlowe is being announced now so businesses can prepare financial smart contracts and products in time for the full release of the Cardano blockchain in 2019. So Marlowe's releasing Plutus and Marlowe, the smart contracting layer is going to be releasing at the end of 2019. So why announce it now? This is a classic marketing technique to institutions. The way I look at it is Cardano is going to be covering all bases. Do you know why they created the KEVM, the Ethereum virtual machine, written with the K framework? So it allows for greater security and reliability of building your Ethereum smart contracts. It's because this is a classic marketing technique. They're going to, when this releases on the mainnet, it's going to allow existing Ethereum contract developers who are building an Ethereum and may need an extra framework in order to verify the validity of their smart contract to understand exactly where or when they went wrong when writing this particular smart contract. And they're going to like it so much that they're going to explore different options that Cardano is going to offer. So this is like a test drive before actually selling the car. You go to a dealership, they let you test drive the car. They let you test drive that new Lexus, or they let you test drive that new Toyota or whatever car dealership you're going to. And you know, you don't own the car, but it's like, oh, look at the functionality of my car. And when you're ready to buy, then you're ready to buy. You know, like, this is exactly what's going to happen. But this is different because I would compare this to, you know, one of them, Cardano, is a, you know, a beautiful car. And these other crypto projects, you know, they're Hot Wheels. They're not offering the same reliability and security as Cardano, you know. Ethereum, you know, it may be a car, but it has no airbags. So, you know, give or take, whatever happens, happens. And, you know, you have a lot of academics that were at PlutusFest, and they're pretty much agnostic as far as investing. You know, like, I don't know if they're investing themselves. I'm sure they are, but it's not really important for them about the price or what's going on in the markets. It's more about the code. They're really passionate about the code and developing the science and mathematical rigor to allow Cardano to succeed. So when you see these people who are, I would say, investing agnostic, meaning that they're not really tied to price, you don't see them in our Telegram group saying, oh, I'm going to become a whale, or, you know, I'm scooping up my bags at 1 cent. That's not their game. They're not even worried about that. They're in a whole different sphere. They're in a whole different world. They were talking about Ethereum. They bring it up quite a few times. And it was kind of like a running joke about how, like, kind of broken Ethereum is. And just like, they're providing the solutions, you know, like, it seems a lot of developers there have actually worked on Ethereum, like they've actually developed on Ethereum, they've used Solidity, and they're just not impressed. They're not impressed, you know. There's like a 60% chance that something goes wrong. You know, they're not impressed, and the solutions are not, they're not impressed by the solutions, they're not impressed by, you know, new papers that are coming out from Ethereum. It's all hogwash at the end of the day. And Cardano is building it right and secure from day one. So if that's not reassuring to see that, you know, there's no competition. You know, I know that Ethereum is much higher in price, much higher in market cap, but still the solid code that you're going to use to build smart contracts on top of Cardano is none other. So let me know what you think. Please like, comment, and subscribe. And until the next video, thank you.